Hi, my name is Jack Late. The first thing I do have to say is you're going to have to excuse my voice. I don't normally talk funny like this. I have a bit of a cold and my nose is blocked. Right, this video is to introduce to everyone a Facebook group that we started a while ago. It's grown quite significantly. The Facebook group is called Elvenar Platinum Leaf. There it is. And it's a resources group where people come together to share information on how to play the game of Elvenar better. I know some people watching this video may not know what Elvenar is. It's a computer browser game. It's on computers, laptops. It's not on mobiles yet. And it's a city building game. So I thought I'd just quickly, for those who don't know about, who haven't played it, don't know it, I'm just going to give you a quick glance at the game, and then I'm going to show you our Facebook group. Right, well now I've gone to the developer's official fan page, and there we go. Let's have a look at the video. Right, well I thought of what I would do now is to show you my city, just quickly, and then begin to go and look at the Facebook group. So, there we go, that's the city. There's the main hall. These thingy jobs here are all residences, with people living in them, and they produce coins for you. These johnnies over here are factories in which I can make different raw materials, like silk and gems. These ones over here making planks. There's an armory over there where we train troops. We fight occasionally little battles on another screen. But anyway, that's just for those who don't know what Elvenar is. This is what a rather developed Elvenar game looks like. I have another one which is sort of more beginner level, so I think I'll just quickly show you that and then we're going to go to the Facebook group. Right, well this is another city of mine that, as you can see, I don't play it. It's only got a main hall. There's the main hall over there. It's got a house. It's got a workshop. It's got a builder's hut where you keep your builders. Good. So now, those who don't know Elvenar, I've seen the game. Maybe I should just build a house quickly and I'll show you. See, we can build one. There we go over there, get houses. And we can plonk it down over there. And now it's building. And you'll see it's going to take 8 seconds. So there are 5, 4. And while it's building, I could, if I want to, just quickly go and build a footpath. Over there we can build a nice footpath. And then next to the footpath we can put another residence. And eventually, the city, if you spend a year building it like I did, then it'll look like the one I showed you before. Right, let me tell you about the Facebook group. I'm going to show you how to get there now, but I just want to tell you in advance what it's all about. There are lots of tricks that allow you to play this game of Elvenar better. So we started a little group, which has now grown very large, actually, where people can join on Facebook, and we've got all kinds of files and resources, and if you want a question, if you want someone to answer your questions, we have people who will do that, and it's generally just a way to dolly up your game a little bit and to get more enjoyment out of it, because instead of being puzzled how things work, there is a place where you can go and get your information. It's a fun group. There's some nice people there. So I'm going to now go there. Right, here we are on Facebook. And I've typed in here Elvenar Platinum Leaf. There we go. There are the search results. That's us. And that's what you'll get. If you type in this search box here, Elvenar Platinum Leaf, you're going to get us. This is also our Facebook community page. That's a group with 1,914 members, as you can see. This is our companion page where we put our presentations and our videos that don't really fit there for technical reasons. So let's go. Right, there we are. Now we are in the group. It's a public group. It's free to share for everyone to join. And I'm going to now show you the pinned post at the top that tells you the description. So let's go there. This is the pinned post. It's pinned right at the top. It's the first thing you'll see when you come in. It's a welcome in which we say that we are a news and resources group. We welcome you to bring all your other fellowship members who play with you, and we also welcome people to make contributions. Of our 1,900 odd members, there are a lot of people who are continually putting in news on a daily basis. We have a lot of participation, we have a lot of fun, we have a lot of chatting, and so on and so forth. Over here, on the side of the pin post, here is the group description. You could read it through when you come to visit us. It's just basically saying that we are sharing, we are helping one another, we're a family-friendly group. We don't complain about the developers here and say nasty things, because that's really not what we're here for. We're here to have fun and to learn. And that's about it. Right, I think what we're going to do now is just to scroll down the news feed and go and have a look at what's happening here. Here's somebody talking about a game issue. Here's Blue Father Tree. Here's Ainsley. Ainsley is now one of the admins, and she's putting up something, a useful point about our tournaments that are on the go at the moment. We'll leave that one. Right, this is quite an interesting one. It's me, myself, who did this. We have a competition on at the moment. So what we've done is I've made a nice picture, and the competition has prizes all every day, and it has special buildings. So what we've done is we have, there we are, we've gone into that post now, and here every single day one, day two, three, four, we're adding as the competition continues. We're making a list which will be useful for future reference for other people. Then there are quests that you have to perform. Also, they follow one after the other, and here's a list of all the quests, which are very useful if you are number 35, let's say, and you're wondering what's coming tomorrow and the next day, then you can look at the list. And then there's a whole lot of information in here about snow crystals, which are part of the competition. And there's a whole lot of gameplay things here telling you, when you're doing this competition, all kinds of little tips that are going to make the game easier. I'm going to scroll through it. You can see there's quite a lot of information here for those who want it. And then we have posts that follow. They're screenshots of, this is the first one that comes up when the competition starts. They're all little explanatory notes on that competition. So this whole thing is basically, this particular post is almost an encyclopedia, because it's got all the information there that people may need, and I even put in Bing Crosby just to make it a little bit more interesting for everyone. And of course every day, as the competition progresses, we get new stuff coming in. There's a new building, it was a prize, and we add it. So it grows and grows and grows, and that is why people, hopefully like yourselves, who join the group will come every day to see what's new. Righty. Now I'm going to show you some of the functionality of the stuff that we have to offer you in the group. If you go to the top here, there is a section called Files. So we'll just click on that. And there we have a whole lot of files. There's one here called Fellowships Seeking Members. That's a link. It will take you to a place where there are videos if you want to watch them. Introduce yourself. I'm going to show you all of these quickly. but you can see we've got quite a lot of file material. So let's go, first of all, just for interest's sake, fellowship seeking members, we'll go there. And here, people put in, that fellowship has 25 members and they only have 22, they're advertising, so they put in little adverts in which to say that they are looking for members. And this one is mine. The best fellowship on the beta world is looking for players. We got one, so this is actually outdated. We'll remove it. But that's how that file works. Here's another one. This is our master index, which Ainsley put together for us. And I'll just click it for you and show you. This is a content index, which Ainsley has very kind of put all these lovely little links in for beginners, certain information that you may find useful, for information about fellowships, general information, how to fight the battles, planning your city, and so on and so on. Right, well, here's some more files. For example, need help with a fight. If people go to that fight, there's a place where you can take a picture of something that you're doing. You don't know what you're doing, you don't know how to do it. And we have experts who will, so-called experts, we're not really blowing our own trumpet too much. We have people who know what's what in the pot. And when the beginners get a problem, they will put a picture of their fight there and we will solve it for them if we can. Then we've got, I showed you fellowship seeking members. We have also people who aren't in a fellowship, who are looking for a fellowship. We do have quite a good success rate with placing people. Let's have a look. Then there's some nice information stuff. This is a file that I put together that shows you how to take a screenshot. And then we've got another file that shows you how to cut and paste out of the game, which is something that is a bit tricky. It's not like a Windows cut and paste. It's a little bit more difficult. Where's the other one? Oh, yes, here's an interesting one. Here, introduce yourself. I'm going to show you this file. Here you can tell us about yourself, if you like, which server, which country, whether you keep goldfish or puppies, anything except rude comments about me or the developers. Or our two admins, Paul has unfortunately left us, but our two admins are Ainsley and Nomar. And if I just scroll down here, there we go, no, that's Michelle. There's me. Hi, I am the founder of this group. I'm an admin with Ainsley Nomar. Nomar is Blood and Slaughters. That's because he's our fighting expert. I live in South Africa. I play Winyandor World. And I enjoy making my own food. I make my own bread, my own cold meat, my own homemade butter, and I have a cat. And if anyone is interested, I'm 58 years old. This is one of the fun parts of Elvenar Platinum Group. We don't just give out information, we have fun. We have little competitions and people like to show pictures of themselves and that kind of thing. Now I thought to show you a new feature of the group, the tournament quick picks. They're tournaments every week in which you fight battles to get points and prizes and things. And a lot of people have had problems with this because the whole fighting system was reworked a couple of months ago and one doesn't really know how to win the fights any longer. So we created this little tip, and every week there are 9 different kinds of tournaments, 9 weeks in a row, and each one is different. So every week we put up a quick pick which gives you an idea of what to do in the tournament. We'll just open this one up. There we go. Going inside. And we'll see. Will we see it? Yes, we will. We have to just go there. We will see that is me congratulating Nomar on having taken this department over. And there's the tip of the week. And I'll show it to you. It says, in a Magic Dust province tournament, these are the enemy that you're going to see there. If you wish to use the appallingly bad auto-fight option because you don't know how to fight yourself, this is sort of a rather shoddy best of a bad, making the best of a bad issue kind of suggestion. And then there's some more detailed stuff about what to use. And we're continually experimenting, and there are two different races in Elvenar. There are humans, and there are elves, and the fighting techniques are different, so we have for both. It's quite comprehensive, and every week we put this out to help people who are perhaps beginners, and to give some tips in order that you can win your tournaments better. So that's one of the really nice things that this group can offer to you. And of course, if you have some good ideas, then you just contact Nomar, and if your idea is good, then he'll incorporate it into this tip. And then of course, as the tournament comes on, here is another one. Their videos. These are videos that Nomar has done for us. I'm not going to open one of the videos, they will be on our YouTube. But he takes a human fight and he takes an elf fight every single week, and he just gives you a nice little video to give you an idea of what that particular week's tournament is all about. Nomar's very good at that. And then let me just show you over here. Earlier today, I discovered a little trick. So I made a little supplementary tip, and this is just a suggestion of when you play the tournament, you get deeper and deeper, it becomes more complicated, and we then discover our original theory wasn't correct, so we bring out these other little supplementaries. It will eventually, we have other stuff from previous weeks, but that's not in this format. The new format started this week. In 9 weeks' time, we will actually have this format for every single province, and then it's a little encyclopedia of fighting. So that's something we really can offer you. Here's another little post. This is the fun side of the group. Today is Saturday. I've taken to putting a little daily message in, silly thing. And then, of course, you'll find that there's quite a lot of discussion that people have things to say about that. Here's another bit of news that I put in yesterday. We had a lot of discussion on this one because it was something that shocked people who hadn't done this particular part of the game yet. You'll see a lot of people here, 15 comments. There was a long, very interesting discussion with everybody putting in their own little contributions and so on and so forth. Well, there you go. This is yesterday's comment. And again, there was 37 people said they liked that. How's that, eh? Well, now I showed you the files, which were over here. Now we can look at our photos. We'll click on photos. We now go to albums, and there we have, these are our videos which Nomar has made for us. Now we have over here, goodness me, hello Ainsley, look at that, she's just saying hi to us, something about new members. notification down on the side of the screen while I was working. Then we have a tip of the day, that's my baby, I'll show that to you. Every day over the last year, we've done little tips. These are beginner's tips. I'm still working on them. They're awfully jumbled up, but they have to be rewritten. This is one of the new ones. You can see we've got it looking rather nicer. These are old ones that are a little bit shoddy, but there's good information. That's why they haven't been deleted. Then we've got basic tips, and we've got how to build a city, how to optimize the layout of your city to get the most buildings in, get the most bang for your buck, smart gameplay tips, all different kinds of things, visiting neighbors, the values of your buildings, scouting on the world map, fellowships. I'm going to show you this one. No, I'll come back to it. Chat and messages, how to use the messenger. I've got to scratch my nose, excuse me. The Magic Academy, the spells, the ancient wonders, the guest races. Ah, we'll go there now. That's the next place we've got to go to. And then, of course, there's the tournaments that I showed you now, the weekly quick pick. Tips for the competitions, that's the one I showed you earlier. These here are old competitions. This is the King Snow and the Snow Flurry competition that's running now. And then we've got some behind-the-scenes stuff, and we have some resources. Just let me go back to where the first one I showed you. That one we come into now. Well, that's funny, isn't it? I actually forgot what I wanted to show you. I wrote this one. Okay, a good fellowship is just like a symphony orchestra. Just to give you an idea of what the tip looks like, let's open it. And there you will see it's number 76. Some thoughts about the camaraderie within a fellowship. And then we'll just open up the tip. There it is. And look in the front. There is the conductor in his tux. We call him the archmage. Then there are the string section. These are the majors. The little guy in the back row with the triangle only gets to strike it a few times. But if he struck it wrong, or fell asleep during a performance, he'd mess the whole thing up. So there you are. There's a little bit of philosophy about fellowships with some tips on how to run a fellowship. That's actually one of our pretty typical tips. Okay, I've come out of that tip now. Now let's just go and have a look over here. Now remember I told you you've got a Facebook community page. Well, the stuff on the community page is linked. So if you can't remember where the community page is, you can just come here. And here is a note that is everything you need to know about the Dwarves chapter. So I think we're just going to go there now. Righty, I could have clicked on that tip and it would have taken us there. But I just thought I would show you. I don't want to come in the back door, I want to go in through the front door. So there is the link for Elvenar Platinum Leaf Community. So we're just going to click that. And that will now take us to the Facebook page, hopefully. Yes, there we go. See, now we've left the Elvenar Platinum Leaf and we're now in the community page. Here is one of Nomar's videos. I don't think I'm going to show it to you now, otherwise this video is going to get impossibly long, but these will be posted. I want to show you here. Click on notes. Okay, now we're in the notes. Ainsley is the architect of most of these. She's very good with graphics, so we all give her the info, but she's the one who does the layout. And we'll go and look at the one that I was... this is one that I did, in fact. This is about the new fighting system, and this is the one where all the provinces are inside with the different troops that you would use to fight battles. But this is the one I mentioned, the dwarves. Isn't this exciting? You're entering chapter 6 and you're about to be introduced to your first guest race, the dwarves. Obviously the newcomers to the game haven't got a clue about guest races, so we've put this together to show you what to do. Let's open it. There it opens. It's a very nice little picture that Ainsley did for us. And there you go. Introductory description, a link that may be useful, the basics. And can you see how beautifully she's done all these little pictures? There's a portal, there's a granite mine. She tells you how many mines you would need. Copper foundries all describe what they do, how you use them. Little tips in between, how to begin. There you go. Unlocking the granite mines, unlocking the copper foundries. Then we have little mathematical tables that show you if you... I'm not mathematical, I just play the game, but there are those who have a pencil and a slide rule. So they're going to be providing that. It's a comprehensive document. It's got everything in it. And this is obviously something that you can share in your fellowship. And this is perhaps one of, together with Nomar's videos, this is perhaps one of the greatest assets that we have to offer, and that is why we're inviting you to all come and join us. Well, that's really all I have to say. This video situation, we've got a whole lot of videos that need to be organized into YouTube, because today is our first day on YouTube. It's very exciting. We're still learning how it works. So you may think this presentation is very rough and ready, but perhaps I'll do it again in 6 months' time when I've learned how to do the thing properly. There are already videos on subjects like how the buttons work, and there's a lot of fighting material from Nomar, how to do fights. We have quite a few, and they aren't on YouTube yet, but they will be appearing in the course of the next couple of days. If you do want to join us, there you go. Elvenar Platinum Leaf on Facebook. My name is Jack. The other two co-owners and admins of the group are Ainsley and Noma. We'll see you there. Cheers.